Hello students, I'm Mrs. Madhavi Salodkar. We have to take summary lecture on probability for TY BCom students, Business Statistics second paper. Definition of permutation. Permutation of distinct objects. A permutation of distinct objects taken R at a time is an ordered arrangement of R objects from these N objects. So formula for NPR is given by N factorial upon N minus R factorial. See the first example. How many three-digit words can be formed using the letters of the word computer? Number of possible ways is equal to, there are 8 letters in the word computer. We have to take any 3. So 8P3, according to the formula, it becomes 8 factorial upon 8 minus 3 factorial, which can be written as 8 factorial upon 5 factorial. Now 8 factorial can be written as 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 factorial divided by 5 factorial. So 5 factorial gets cancelled with 5 factorial. So product of 8, 7, 6 is the answer, which is nothing but 336. Next definition, combination. A combination of n different objects taken R at a time is a selection of only R objects out of these n objects without regard to the order in the selection. So NCR is equal to n factorial upon R factorial upon n minus R factorial. R should be less than or equal to n. So NCR can be written as NPR upon factorial R. Example, a committee of 4 persons is to be formed from 10 persons. Find the number of possible ways. So number of possible ways is equal to 10C4, which is nothing but 10 factorial upon 4 factorial into 10 minus 4 factorial, which is equal to 10 factorial upon 4 factorial into 6 factorial. Now 10 factorial can be written as 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 factorial. 4 factorial can be written as 4 into 3 into 2 into 6 factorial. 6 factorial gets cancelled with 6 factorial. 4 to the 8 cancels with 8 directly. 3 1 the 3 3 is 9. So the product of 10, 3 and 7, the number of possible ways is equal to 210. Next concept, sample space. The set of all possible distinct outcomes of an experiment is called a sample space. It is denoted by omega. For example, consider the experiment of rolling of a die. Sample space omega is given by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Event. An event is a subset of a sample space. Example of an event. In an experiment of rolling of a die, let A denote the event that even number appears on the uppermost face. So favorable outcomes for event A are 2, 4, 6. Next concept, mutually exclusive events. Events A and B, defined on a sample space omega, are said to be mutually exclusive if there is no common element in A and B. That is, A intersection B is equal to 5. For example, consider the experiment of rolling of a die. Let A is the event that an even number appears uppermost, and B is the event that an odd number appears on the uppermost face. So omega is given by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Favorable outcomes for event A are 2, 4, 6. And outcomes for B are 1, 3, 5. So if you also set A and set B, there is no single element common in both the events. So we can say that A intersection B is equal to 5. Next definition, exhaustive events. Events A and B defined on the sample space omega are said to be exhaustive if and only if A union B is equal to omega. Consider the experiment of rolling of a die. Let A be the event of getting an even number and B is the event of getting an odd number. So we can write omega as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Event A can be written as 2, 4, 6 and B can be written as 1, 3, 5. So if you calculate, if you write A union B, the concept of A union B is element either in A or in B or in both. So we can say that A union B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So which is nothing but omega. Next definition, probability of an event. If a random experiment results in n mutually exclusive and equally likely outcomes, out of which m are favorable to the event A, then the probability of occurrence of the event A is denoted by P of A and is given by probability of A is equal to m upon n, which can be written as number of elements belonging to event A divided by total number of elements in the sample space omega. The important theorem on probability, we can state addition theorem on probability. Probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability B minus probability A intersection B. See the example based on this concept. A bag contains 30 tickets numbered from 1 to 30. One ticket is selected at random. Find the probability that its number is either odd or the square of an integer. So omega can be written as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 30. Let A be the event that the number on the ticket drawn is odd and B be the event that the number on the ticket drawn is a square of an integer. So we can write A as 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17, 19, 21, 23, 25, 27, 29. B is the event. So the outcomes are 1, 4, 9, 16, 25. So if you see the common elements of A and B, we can write A intersection B as 1, 9, 25. Probability of A can be written as n of A upon n of omega, which is nothing but 15 upon 30. Probability of B is nothing but n of B upon n of omega. So it is nothing but 5 upon 30. And probability of A intersection B is equal to n of A intersection B upon n of omega. So there are 3 favorable outcomes for A intersection B. So probability can be written as 3 upon 30. So probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability B minus probability A intersection B. So we can write this as 15 upon 30 plus 5 upon 30 minus 3 upon 30. So the final answer is 17 upon 30. Next concept, independence of two events. Two events A and B defined on a sample space omega are said to be independent if and only if probability of A intersection B is equal to probability of A into probability B. So example, consider an experiment of rolling of a die. A is the event of occurrence of an even number. B is the event of occurrence of a number greater than 4. So rolling of a die, sample space omega can be given as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. A is nothing but 2, 4, 6. Favorable outcomes for B are 5 and 6. A intersection B can be written as 6. So probability of A is equal to 3 upon 6. Probability B is equal to 2 upon 6. And probability of A intersection B is equal to 1 upon 6. So if you multiply probability of A into probability B, we are getting the answer as 3 upon 6 into 2 upon 6, which can be written as 6 upon 36, which is equal to 1 by 6, and we can say this is equal to probability of A intersection B. Therefore, events A and B are independent. See the example based on this concept. Suppose a card is drawn at random from a well-shuffled pack of playing cards. Let A is the event of getting a spade card, B is the event of getting a king card. Are A and B independent? Let A is the event of getting a spade card. So probability of A can be written as 13 upon 52. B is the event of getting a king card. So probability B can be written as 4 upon 52 because there are 4 kings in a pack. The meaning of A intersection B is nothing but king of spade. So we know that there is only one king of spade. So probability of A intersection B is equal to 1 upon 52. Now probability of A into probability B, if you multiply, we can write these values as 13 upon 52 into 4 upon 52. So 13 for the 52 gets cancelled with 52 directly. So the answer is 1 upon 52, which is equal to probability of A intersection B. Therefore, events A and B are independent. Conditional probability of A given B. Suppose A and B are two events defined on sample space omega. Then the conditional probability of A given B, denoted by probability of B, A slash B, is defined as probability of A given B is equal to probability of A intersection B divided by probability B. In this case, probability B must be greater than 0. Similarly, conditional probability of B given A is equal to probability B slash A is equal to probability of A intersection B divided by probability of A. In this case, probability of A must be greater than 0. See the example. A card is drawn from a pack of playing cards. What is the probability that it is a king, given that it is a face card? A face card is either jack or a queen or a king. So let A be the event that the card drawn is a king, B be the event that the card drawn is a face card. So probability of A given B is equal to probability of A intersection B upon probability B, which can be written as 4 upon 52 because there are 4 kings out of 52 playing cards, and divided by 12 upon 52 because there are 12 face cards. So the final answer is equal to 4 upon 12, which can be written as 1 by 3. Bayes theorem. Suppose events A1, A2, A3 up to AN form a partition of a sample space omega of a random experiment. Suppose B is any other event with probability B greater than 0 defined on sample space omega. Then probability of AI given B is equal to probability of AI into probability B given AI divided by summation over J is equal to 1 to M probability AJ into probability B given AJ for all I is equal to 1 to N. See the example based on this concept. There are 4 boys and 2 girls in room number 1 and 5 boys and 3 girls in room number 2. A girl from one of the rooms laughed loudly. What is the probability that the girl who laughed loudly was from room number 2? Let us define events A1, A2 and B as, let A1 be the event that the girl from room number 1 laughed loudly. A2 is the event that the girl from room number 2 laughed loudly. B is the event that the girl laughs loudly. Probability of A1 is equal to 0.5 because selection of first room and selection of second room. So probability of A2 is equal to 0.5. Now probability of B given A1. The meaning of B given A1 is girl from room number 1. So there are 2 girls out of 6. So probability of B given A1 is nothing but 2 upon 6. And probability B given A2 can be written as 3 upon 8 because there are 3 girls out of 8 in the room number 2. So we have to find the probability of A2 given B, which we can write it as probability of A2 into probability B given A2 divided by probability of A1 into probability B given A1 plus probability A2 into probability B given A2. Now replace the values in the formula, which is equal to 0.5 into 0.375 divided by 0.5 into 0.3333 plus 0.5 into 0.375. So if you multiply the values, we are getting the answer as 0.1875 divided by 0.16665 plus 0.1875. So the numerator is 0.1875 divided by 0.35415. So if you divide these two values, we are getting the final answer as 0.52943. Let's see some examples based on concept of independent events and Bayes' theorem. First example, a husband and wife appear for two vacancies in the same post. The probability of husband's selection is 1 upon 7 and that of wife's selection is 1 by 5. What is the probability that, first part of the problem, both of them will be selected. Second part of the problem, only one of them will be selected. Third part of the problem, none of them will be selected. Let A be the event of husband selection. B is the event of wife selection. Here A and B are independent. We are given that probability of A is equal to 1 upon 7. Probability of B is equal to 1 by 5. In the first part of the problem, we need probability both of them will be selected. So we can apply the definition of independent events as probability of A intersection B can be written as probability of A into probability B, which is equal to 1 upon 7 into 1 upon 5. That is nothing but 1 upon 35. Therefore, probability that both of them will be selected is equal to 1 upon 35. In the second part, we need only one of them will be selected. It means probability A intersection B complement plus probability A complement intersection B. Now, A intersection B complement can be written as probability of A into probability B complement because A and B are independent. So, which is equal to 1 by 7 into 4 by 5, which is nothing but 4 by 35. And probability of A complement intersection B is given as probability of A complement into probability B, which is equal to 6 by 7 into 1 by 5, which is equal to 6 by 35. Now add both the values to get only one person is selected. Therefore, probability A intersection B complement is plus probability A complement intersection B is equal to 4 upon 35 plus 6 upon 35, which is nothing but 10 upon 35. Third part of the problem, none of them will be selected. It means probability of A complement intersection B complement. So A and B are independent, so we can write this as probability of A complement into probability B complement. Probability of A complement can be given as 6 by 7 and probability of B complement is 4 by 5. So 6 by 7 into 4 by 5, the final answer is 24 upon 35. Next example. The probability of an accident in a factory in a year is 0.3 in Pune and 0.1 in Mumbai. Find the probability that an accident may happen in, first part of the problem, at least one of the cities. Second part of the problem, both the cities. Let A be the event that the accident happens in Pune. B is the event that an accident happens in Mumbai. We are given that probability of A is equal to 0.3 and probability B is equal to 0.1. Events A and B are independent. Therefore, probability of A into probability B is nothing but probability of A intersection B. So probability of A intersection B can be calculated as 0.3 into 0.1, which is equal to 0.03. Now, to get the first part of the problem, that the accident may happen in at least one of the two cities, we will apply addition theorem on probability as probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability B minus probability A intersection B. So which can be written as 0.3 plus 0.1 minus 0.03. So which is the 0.3 plus 0.1 becomes 0.4 minus 0.03 becomes 0.37. Second part of the problem, probability that accident happens in both the cities is nothing but probability of A intersection B, which we already have calculated as 0.3 into 0.1, which is equal to 0.03. Next example, probability that a man will be alive 20 years hence is 0.3, and probability that his wife will be alive 20 years hence is 0.4. Find the probability that after 20 years, first part of the problem, both will be alive. Second part of the problem, only the wife will be alive. Third part of the problem, at least one of them will be alive. And fourth part of the problem, only the man will be alive. So let's define the events. Let A be the event that the man will be alive 20 years hence. And B is the event that his wife will be alive 20 years hence. Given that, probability of A is equal to 0.3. Probability B is equal to 0.4. Events A and B are independent. Therefore, probability that both of them will be alive is nothing but probability of A intersection B, which can be written as probability of A into probability B. So which is nothing but 0.3 into 0.4. So probability that both of them will be alive is given by 0.12. Next part of the problem, probability that only wife will be alive is given by probability of A complement intersection B, which is equal to probability of A complement into probability B, which is equal to 0.7 into 0.4. The answer is 0.28. Third part, at least one of them will be alive. We can apply the addition theorem on probability. Probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability B minus probability A intersection B. So replace all the values in the formula. We are getting the answer as 0.3 plus 0.4 minus 0.12. So the answer is 0.58. And the last part of the problem, only the man will be alive, is given by probability of A intersection B complement is equal to probability of A into probability B complement, which is nothing but 0.3 into 0.8, which is equal to 0.18. Next example, a town has three doctors A, B and C operating independently. The probability that doctor A is available is 0.9 and that for B is 0.6, for C it is 0.7. What is the probability that at least one doctor is available when needed? Now define events A. Let A be the event that Dr. A is available, B is the event that Dr. B is available, and C is the event that Dr. C is available. Given that probability of A is 0.9, probability B is equal to 0.6, probability C is equal to 0.7. Doctors A, B, C are operating independently. Therefore, probability A intersection B is equal to probability of A into probability B, which can be written as 0.9 into 0.6, which is equal to 0.54. Probability A intersection C is equal to probability of A into probability C, which is equal to 0.9 into 0.7, which is nothing but 0.63. Probability B intersection C is given as probability B into probability C, which is nothing but 0.6 into 0.7. So we can write it as 0.42. And probability of A intersection B intersection C, the answer is probability of A into probability B into probability C, which is nothing but 0.9 into 0.6 into 0.7, the answer is 0.378. Now apply the addition theorem on probability for three events. Probability of A union B union C is nothing but probability of A plus probability B plus probability C minus probability A intersection B minus probability A intersection C minus probability B intersection C plus probability A intersection B intersection C. Replace all the values in the given formula. We can write probability of A union B union C as 0.9 plus 0.6 plus 0.7 minus 0.54 minus 0.63 minus 0.42 plus 0.378. We add and subtract according to their signs. The final answer comes out to be 0.988. C1 problem based on Bayes' theorem. A company has two plants to manufacture scooters. Plant 1 manufactures 70% of the scooters and plant 2 manufactures 30%. At plant 1, 80% of scooters are rated standard quality, and at plant 2, 90% of scooters are rated standard quality. A scooter is picked up at random and found to be of standard quality. What is the probability that it has come from plant 1? This is the problem based on Bayes' theorem. So first of all, we will define the events A1, A2 and B. Let A1 is the event that production from first plant. A2 is the event of production from the second plant. And B is the event that a scooter is of standard quality. Now see the things which are given to us. Probability of A1 is 0.7. Probability of A2 is 0.3. They form a partition. Their total probability is 1. Probability B given A1 is 0.8. Probability B given A2 is 0.9. First plant standard quality scooters are 80%. And second plus plant standard quality scooters are 90%. So, and we have to find probability of A1 given B. So we will apply the Bayes' theorem on probability, that is nothing but probability of A1 into probability B given A1 divided by probability A1 into probability B given A1 plus probability A2 into probability B given A2. Replace the values, we are getting it as 0.7 into 0.8 divided by 0.7 into 0.8 plus 0.3 into 0.9. So the products are, probability A1 given B is equal to 0.56 divided by 0.56 plus 0.27. So the final division is nothing but 0.56 divided by 0.83. The final answer is 0.6746.